east, and there's no other way to go anyway. So it's more like a loop, a Z4 for those who are interested in mathematics. It's a cyclic loop with four elements. Mathematics now and mathematics out. This one, talking about mathematics, has a more interesting group, and I'll go to there soon. This one is a different phase, and you have to understand how to go from one phase, one emotion, to another one. It had eight different emotions. And this is how you go there. This is if you do a circle, when you do the cylinder one, you go back to... And this is when you do the star move. And depending on how you do the star move, because you open it, and the other side below, you go to a different... If you do it vertically or horizontally, you go to a different way. So it was like exactly like the operations for the dihedral group of eight elements. And for this reason, I really like this puzzle. This is why I made me know. Poseidon tridents. This is also a very difficult puzzle. And it has a myth. It has a solution, two times one solution. So two times one. And the one double flat solution with one loop continuously, with all those tridents following one single path. And it is said by myth, which I have not proved yet, or if it's wrong or not, that there's another solution where there's two loops. There are two loops. I have not found the other solution. I still have a couple of copies of this one, but not with me, unfortunately. But I didn't have the time to.
Yeah, actually, kind of getting a little bit back to what we're saying, especially all like cuberts and Simon's tribes,
yes.
When you end up with a cubic forms, it's really, really difficult to solve because you know you're scared to death that the strings.
This is why it's double strings.
Right, but it's still scary, so just wondering if there's ever going to be...
This doesn't require anything that goes
a
bit weird. So if it's a bit weird, you do something wrong. So don't... There's a very simple move. I have a sequence, very simple, that actually make it into this shape. So what you're going to have to choose is to have the correct starting point when it's flat. And that's easy, but easy in a sense, you know.
Yeah, I forgot the green line, so.
But I have, if you go to the Twisty Puzzle Forum, I have
a lot of that's been taken down.
Even a video.
Yeah.
Anyone who cannot find them, I can give them elsewhere, you can email me, it's very easy. Now, hexagonal ones. Now, this was almost a failed prototype, so it was quite bad. I won't go into that. I tried to do something simpler than tangents. Puzzle, flexible hexagon. So, before I go here, I should go here first. And then I did this one hexagonal one, the closed loop. And this was quite nice. I made a video of this on YouTube, and it works very interesting for four tiles. So, but unfortunately, as you can see, it was quite bad, the quality. So, it didn't help me. But if I had a good quality tiles, it would be very wonderful. Now, going back to here. Excuse me. Sorry.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome. And if you remember, the four tile one had the dihedral group. The other one had Z4. This one is called Z8 because it has eight elements, which means that on the left, there's a zero. By doing the same manipulation, you can go one by one, one here, two, three, all eight numbers. It is interesting, this is scrambled here, but this one always shows a number. The other side is scrambled as well. So you always going to have at one side, on the left, one specific number, from zero to eight, which is the number of all flat states for this puzzle. And then this was a double cube. The first one who did this was Tim Brown. And I used a domino thing here. And you can do either white or black. And the top one and the bottom one should always add up to seven, as like Roman guys. This other puzzle, this was also, this is the puzzle I made. This is a puzzle that was copied by in China. Somebody saw it, and this is different than 12 tile for Ruby. It's different, it's completely different. It's actually similar to the Singaporean one that you saw before. And here, it's 12 hearts, and the other side there's 12 red hearts, which are not, which are a bit turned around. So going from the red, from the blue to the red one, every other hearts are the same orientation like the big heart, it's not very easy. And it's called Valentine's heart because it's a dedication to show how much someone loves his pearl. So now this one was done just like that. We had a double solution, so there was nothing mathematical about this. We just copied the, let's see. This is a nice one. We have a rose, and then the rose becomes something else, something very wonderful. It comes into a heart. I have this one, I think I might have it with me, so if people who are interested, I can actually show it to you. It's a very nice one. And this is the one we saw before. It's similar to the hard one, but it has a Singaporean theme because I like a lot of three countries, Australia, Greece, and Singapore. And of course, Singapore Airlines, this has a flight theme, so it's a bit different than the other one. And of course, I did the football one, it's a football. And another one which is quite nice was, this was, again, the frame, as Wallace likes to call it, but I made a rabbit. And you can make both two rabbits, one with the red color and one with the blue color. So I think it was very cute, but oh, it wasn't easy, but it was very cute. And of course, many of you know Mr. Twisty, which was my extensive puzzle last August, where we had two double solutions. So it was, I managed to